All right, guys, it is time for entertainment news. First up, Burna Boy's My Money, My Baby makes Michelle Obama's workout playlist. Now, it's 2020 and there is still no stopping for the African giant Burna Boy, as his new song, My Money, My Baby, has been listed amongst the songs on the former First Lady of the United States of America, Michelle Obama's workout playlist. Now, the Floatus made this known via Twitter, where she wrote, and I quote, "It's about that time when New Year's resolutions get a bit harder to stick to. To offer a little inspiration, I want to share my go-to workout playlist with you. These songs always seem to give me that extra boost to get through my toughest workout. What's on your playlist?" Now, other artists whose songs make 35-song workout playlist include Ed Sheeran, Calvin Harris, Beyonce, Cardi B, Kanye West, Jay-Z, Lizzo, and also Afrobeat representing Africa, and Tobe Wingwe. Hey!
Ooh. This is massive. But I mean, I think the Obamas generally are into Nigerian music. I remember, like, Plutus also talking about Rema, I think, Iron Man, a couple of months ago.
Burna Boy,
playlist of the year.
Yeah.
It's the thing about others list, you know why it's good? People that don't even know about your song, because it's from Michelle Obama.
It's like,
go check it.
It's like,
Loki.
Okay, what's she listening to? Mm-hmm. Okay, I would love to listen to what she's listening to. Mm. Okay, since this song is good for workout, I would love to work out with this song. And it's giving more PR too. And it's great to see Burna Boy on this list again.
Yeah.
She's Burna Boy is on her husband's list. His new song, which my baby, my money, my money. It's a sample of Fela. You can always tell that the beat will be up tempo. That's why she can work out with the song. And also there's Joanna Afrobeat on that playlist. And of course Tobe Wingwe. And of course Tobe, who is Nigerian, but is based in the US.
Okay.
But we just have to still farm that. We have our brother.
It's our brother.
I mean, this is a big deal.
Our brother.
I mean, for them to be feeling Nigerian music this way. And I also like the fact that they're being very open about their playlist, their interest and all of that. Because some people might look at it like, oh, as you said, oh, PR, oh, why are we doing this? They're benefiting from it. What are we getting from it? I just love the fact that it's just, here is a little piece of my life that I want to share with you. It's so organic. It's so real.
So you saying
now, Loki, someone will be looking for how to pay.
Yeah, true.
Do you understand?
Are you saying this thing? I'm just wondering if a Nigerian politician wants to do something like this, and people will be like, this is not what we want from you. This is not what we want from you. Go and do Rome.
No, but then the reason why people can appreciate this is because they, during their time, they did what they were meant to do.
Yeah.
They worked. So it's time to chill. And I mean, chill we go. Like, whenever they even post pictures when they're on vacation, it's like, girls, we love them together. Yeah. So, I mean,
it was even Michelle's birthday a couple of days back, and he posted this really cute picture of them together. And I really like what you said about, you know, the fact that they did what they were meant to do. And if you even looked during their tenure, Barack Obama was very, very playful. He would crack jokes and everything. It doesn't have to be so serious. You don't have to carry politics on your head like that's the only thing you do. I mean, I think I love.
What politician would you like to
know? I was about to ask.
Yeah.
What politician would you like to know what he listens to?
Dino Melaye.
Wow.
Actually,
what kind of songs do you think will be there?
Ah, Naira Marley.
Well, his own songs. Dino Melaye's song. Anyways, let's just move on.
Oh, well, let's just move on to the foreign scene, guys. Rihanna. And her billionaire boyfriend, Hassan Jameel, have broken up, guys. What? Singer Rihanna and her Saudi Arabian billionaire boyfriend, Hassan Jameel, have reportedly broken up after nearly 3 years of dating. According to sources, there has been no reason as why the two have decided to go their separate ways, and neither Rihanna nor Jameel have issued a statement about the situation. Now, just so you know, the now estranged lovers, who are both 31, first sparked romance rumors in 2017, where they were spotted making out in a hot tub in Ibiza, Spain. In a different twist, over the weekend, Rihanna was spotted hanging out with American rapper A$AP Rocky, and from the pictures circulating online, both of them seemed to be having a lot of fun. Rihanna and A$AP Rocky have been linked in the past. In 2013, they were spotted kissing during the filming of their music video, Fashion Killer. I will definitely be watching this one for sure. I mean, yesterday...
I've been asking the old word for tea.
I want to know.
She just broke up.
A couple of hours ago. I'm wondering if we're gonna get an album out of it or something. That would be so cool.
Like, I saw the pictures and they were happy, smiling.
They are just friends. What is wrong with you?
ASAP and Rihanna.
Yeah. Mm. So it's just like, oh, God forbid I break up with my boyfriend, and then I'm now taking nice pictures with Goji, and then I say, ah, they
are
dating.
Why are we laughing?
Why are we laughing?
She just broke up with a billionaire.
So it's not about herself. Money, and then Rihanna also has a lot of money get level. So no talk that one. But it's not about
Fijian side came
like, hey, you can't compare Saudi Arabian oil. That money is like, well, it does not have anything. It's just going to take down. What? So Rihanna's one still has finishing points, but that aside, I believe that happiness is, you know, the best thing. And that's an example of it. If she's not happy in it, she would have, maybe that's why she left. But I want to talk about the fact that I want Rihanna to continue singing. I miss her so much.
And there was a time someone tweeted at her and said something about her not doing music. I'm doing something. Like, the fact that I'm not doing music doesn't mean that I'm not relevant. I'm still doing stuff.
Yeah, we know she has an empire now, but I just miss her. Because yesterday, people were just playing Rihanna's music back to back, maybe because of the situation. And I just didn't realize how much I miss her talent. So I went to go download the album. But that's
another day. It's crazy. Still Rihanna. Talking about the relationship. There have been a whole lot of speculation. You see Rihanna bloated, and people are saying, wow, this guy has knocked Rihanna. Finally, Rihanna will settle down and get married. I'm seeing this news over the weekend. It's like, we thought this was everything.
How would Chris Brown be feeling right now?
Chris Brown has his own baby mama, and they're doing good.
No. But talking about Chris Brown, some Hollywood insiders said that he's happy about this split, and that it might cause a strain in the relationship between her, him and Mika, which is his baby mama of two now.
Just give birth now.
I don't know.
Chris Brown never came back from that whole Rihanna thing.
He didn't. So what else is going on under
Rihanna's picture and putting love emoji?
Exactly. So Loki's happy.
Yes. Let's move on to your next story. Game of Thrones prequel House of the Dragon to premiere in 2022. Yes, fans of the series Game of Thrones should be excited as Unbox Office has announced when the series prequel House of the Dragon will premiere. According to HBO programming chief Kelsey Bloys, who made the announcement at an event, he said, and I quote, "They're in the room breaking story right now. My guess is we will see it on the air in 22. House of Dragon is based on George R.R. Martin's 2019 book Fire and Blood. The book, which is set 300 years before the events of Game of Thrones, relates the history of the Targaryens, beginning with the Aegon the Conqueror's initial conquest of Westeros, and is bringing the Seven Kingdoms under Israel. According to HBO, House of the Dragon is one of the four remaining Game of Thrones spin-offs in the works. The others are on hold, which could be indefinite or temporary. So for fans of Game of Thrones, this is exciting. I know Arike cannot relate.
Of course.
Yeah, I am so...
Really?
The only thing
I know in this is Khaleesi. And because they posted somebody's picture.
Don't call it in a Yoruba way.
And because I was like, who is that? Khaleesi. No, but OJ, on a more serious note, I love Game of Thrones. I didn't finish it to the end. I watched the last season because everybody was talking about it. And then I'm like, oh, the fitting way to end this beautiful series. Why are they doing a prequel?
So because of fans who still want more, they still want this story.
It will not come out spoiling
it.
So that's why they're now taking us back 300 years before the Game of Thrones, so that people will see what happened before the Game of Thrones. You know, there are fans that they just want all these things to just keep going on. Some people life stopped. When this series was about to finish, people were like, what will happen to my life again? What will I do every weekend?
Like
what will
you.
I be doing every weekend? No, I'm not that guy.
You said it. You said it too.
No, there are some people that are worse, by the way.
Wow.
Anyway, so we're super excited. 2022 is a long time.
It's a long time.
We don't wait.
It's not a long time, but close your eye, open it, it's 2022.
Speak for yourself, all right? I'm still in January 2020. For yourself.